Hello, everyone.
Hello. We have a plan.
With this thread, we want to challenge the digital society.
What do you think? What would happen if the people of a city were all connected with exactly this thread? It would create a completely new network, an analog network, as a supplement to the digitalization, to the fiber optic network.
An analog thread network. That sounds quite absurd. But how would living together be changed in a city that actually realizes it? I am convinced that the city which will do this will no longer be the same city.
Okay, slowly. Before we will explain this in details, we have to speak about our main motive. The unusual action. An unusual action breaks with all the rules and shakes the reality behind the normal.
We are all captured in our daily routine, and it's difficult to break out. I am sure that each of you already did unusual actions. If not, have you never dreamed of it?
I dream, for example, of official timetables without destinations. Have you ever deliberately taken the wrong train? I did it a few times, and I can tell you, it's quite a fantastic breakout to surprise yourself.
20 years ago, I once went, to surprise myself, to the solarium in midsummer. It was 35 degrees outside. Thanks to this unusual action, I got to know my girlfriend, and we are still together.
The unusual action is like a shower outside of your habits, a really fresh kick in your daily life. To act unusual is a good training to create new situations that otherwise would never happen.
We are firmly convinced that unusual actions can change your personal life. And the good thing is, you can do it every day at any time. You certainly know the saying, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. We are saying, an unusual action a day keeps the routine away.
But what we actually find much more interesting is the collective unusual action. Since 20 years, our studio for special tasks has realized different kinds of collective unusual actions, with the aim to create new realities. Three examples.
In 2004, we realized the unusual performance with the presidents of the six smallest political villages in Switzerland and the neighboring countries. They all met for a summit on the top of a mountain in Switzerland, as a poetical counterinvention to the big summits, like the G8.
Or in 2012, we mobilized a whole village together with an insecticide producer to save flies. And to reflect the ambivalent relationship between human and insects. After this action, the insecticide producer changed his whole business model from killing insects to saving them.
And since 8 years, we are working on a long-term social experiment with the population of an entire region. Our vision is to collect old fabrics and to collectively create a picnic blanket for all people out of it. The maxim is one fabric per resident. The picnic blanket is growing from year to year and is laid out somewhere once a year as a new collective tradition. So, our experience is collective unusual actions can transform societies and make new realities happen.
Or in other words, the more the people are acting unusual, the bigger the impact on their reality. 1 year ago, we have started a new collective unusual action in a small village close to Zurich. And there we made a test. And so we come back to this thread.
We asked ourselves, will digitalization be followed by analogization? Everyone is talking about digitalization. But who speaks of analogization?
Isn't there a risk or a danger that the digitalization will attack the human existence day after day? Do the instincts of our human behavior become more and more inactive?
According to futurologists, humanity has to revolutionize itself if it doesn't want to abolish itself through the digitalization excess. The more digital the world, the greater the risk of zombization.
In our view, zombies are like a software on two legs. They ignore you when you greet them on the street. The fact is, we live in a time of big change. Many people are looking for identity and solidarity in real life. Virtual relationships open up new possibilities, of course, but also non-commitment, depersonalization, and social isolation.
Many people long for real social contacts again. The digital exchange doesn't provide an equivalent substitute for the analog feeling of closeness. That's why we see the importance of installing an analog thread network.
The goal is to connect all households with a fabric thread as an answer to digital networking, as a kind of social nearing in a global time of social distancing.
In a first step, we collect lots of thread resources from the people. For that, we go from door to door. Let's take a look. Das versuchen möglichst einfach, ohne lange philosophische Exkurs. Mhm. Hallo.
Hallo.
Wir sind Frank und der Paddy Ricklin. Wir sind im Limmatal unterwegs und suchen Fadenreste.
Super. So,
habe
ich meinen Beitrag
geleistet. Ja, ja. Das ist so einfach. Also Fadenreste.
Ja, also ich kann auch ein Stück abschneiden, oder?
Ein Stück abschneiden, ja.
Kann ich schon, ja.
Die Idee ist, dass im Prinzip dadurch das Bewusstsein fürs Limmatal oder das Zusammenleben im Limmatal an Bedeutung gewinnt, oder? Nein, wir verkaufen nichts, wir versuchen im Prinzip die Leute zu involvieren in einem grösseren Projekt, das alle Limmatalerinnen und Limmataler betrifft.
Vielleicht wird man später mal sagen, ja, die Limmataler, die sind irgendwie anders drauf. Sie ist ein anderes Völkchen. Und vielleicht kann der Vater etwas beitragen zu dem anderen Völkchen. Und wenn man lesen sagt, das ist das Gebiet mit dem analogen Vater.
The strategy is to touch the people by face-to-face situations. By irritation. It's like an attack on reality.
And when we explain our vision, we very often feel that the people have a great desire for exceptional moments. And that they want to be part of something special, to be part of a story. By giving a thread, they become a part.
In a second step, together with the residents, we lay the thread through all houses and flats, gardens and streets. Take a look.
Das sind dort verschiedene Teile. Ich schaue einfach ein bisschen hin und her und dann reindrücken. Da geht schön schweizerisch.
Eigentlich ist es eine Skulptur von einer unüblichen Gemeinschaft.
Ein Projekt, das eigentlich den vermeintlichen Irrsinn versucht, auf eine lustvolle Art und Weise zu thematisieren.
Das ist eine neue gesellschaftliche Massnahme. Man tut sich bewusst verfetalisieren.
Ist es nur ein Traum? Träumen wir viele, ist es mehr? Okay. Träumen wir alle miteinander, ist es sicher der Anfang von etwas Neuem.
Hallo, Herr Huwiler? Sind Sie der Huwiler, oder?
Ja, ja. Hey.
Der Analog Thread Network, or in short, the ATN, provokes new communities. It creates situations and stories that bring the people, or that connect the people with each other and brings them into a relationship in a new, unusual way. And this is exactly the moment where the social sculpture of the rehumanization of the digital society begins.
To clarify, we have no fundamental problem with the digitalization. We don't see the analogization as a replacement for the digital, but as an opposite pole and a return to the tangible, the concrete, the real.
All situations, effects, and opinions that are triggered by the actual laying of the thread fulfill the conceptual idea of our artistic intention.
Exactly. And just to have a discourse about sense or nonsense of our actions has an impact.
Also meinst du, müssten wir unter den Stein durch?
Da?
Ja.
Die sind 15 cm. Die sind Beton innen. Und es geht mit dem Schnürli da durch. Das Wasser kommt. Beispiel, da siehst du, was das Wasser durchgeht. Da schwemmt es dir raus, da hast du nichts mehr.
Wie könnte man es lösen denn?
Gar nicht machen. Hey, das ist fertig gesagt. Da schwemmt er raus und da.
Ja, ich bin nicht ganz sicher.
Sehr das bringt 100'000%. Und wenn ich 100 werde, sage ich es nochmal. Da bringt gar nichts.
Aber wir müssen
gleich nicht
das
tun. Ja, das ist Kunst.
Ja, eben, das wollte ich gerade sagen. Das mit Bringen hat ja das nichts zu tun. Dass das irgendwann verrottet, ist ja jedem bewusst.
Ja. Oder?
Aber ob die Art und Weise, das zu realisieren mit dem dazu, ob das überhaupt vonnöten ist, ohne dass euer Kunstgedanke Schaden leidet, oder?
Es ist eigentlich ein Wechselspiel zwischen Handlung und Kopf. Deshalb machen wir auch diesen Test, damit wir eben weiterkommen. Also sowohl im Kopf wie auch, aber auch praktisch.
Da kann ich viel lieber in Spontan ab und zu für 10 Flaschen Bier, ja mehr davon oder dem.
We know, we actually produce strange situations. Because we push the border of the conventional, the norms. And often then, the question of meaning comes up.
The people suddenly realize, the more serious we mean it, the more insecure they become. They cannot imagine that something meaningful can flow through this analog thread. Certainly no data, but emotions.
After this test, the project was stopped by the authorities. They told us it would polarize and split minds too much. Frank and I, we were very disappointed.
Yes. But it would not be us if we would give up. Our art doesn't break that quickly. We made a public call for all Swiss cities to get in touch with us if they were interested in installing the ATN in their city. And a half a year later, very surprisingly, we received a phone call from Altstetten. Altstetten is located in eastern Switzerland and has 12,000 inhabitants. We met the mayor and the city council to discuss and set all details for the implementation. And now, 3 weeks ago, we actually restarted the project. Here is the mayor of the city of Altstetten, Mr. Rudi Matle, explaining why he thinks the ATN is important for his town with its community.
Erstens haben wir in den vergangenen Jahrzehnten unglaubliche technologische Fortschritte gemacht, während immer sozial keine vergleichbaren Entwicklungsschritte gemacht haben. Das analoge Fadernetz wird eine soziale Dynamik auslösen. Eine Dynamik, die neue Ideen und neue Visionen für ein positives Zusammenleben in Altstädten generieren wird. Zweitens leben wir in einer immer digitalisierteren Welt und in einer Informationsblase, wo wir nur noch die Informationen bekommen, die uns in unserer Meinung bestärken. Andere Informationen werden zunehmend ausblendet. Das analoge Fadernetz vernetzt uns neu, verbindet uns mit anderen Menschen und anderen Überzeugungen. Wir werden wieder lernen, die andere Seite anzuschauen. Wir werden wieder lernen, konträre Meinungen zu akzeptieren und miteinander konstruktiv zu streiten. Und zum Dritten werden wir miteinander gemeinsam ein analoges Fadernetz bauen, wo ein Faden durch jedes Haus, durch jede Wohnung in Altstädten gehen wird. Und ich weiss, der Faden bei mir in der Stube ist verbunden mit jeder anderen Stube in Altstädten. Das schafft Gemeinsamkeit, das schafft Identität. Identität, die nach innen wirkt und nach außen strahlt.
In this sense, act unusual. Because society of the future world needs your unusual analog act. Thank you.
Thank you.